Hey guys,
my name is Kianche and welcome to episode 22 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about the automation of crop and tree farms using logistics pipes, and in this episode we'll start talking about alloy creation using Tinker's Construct and of course again logistics pipes. So let's get started. So, as you can see, I got myself a pretty interesting setup, which might not be the most optimal for your build, but this will have a lot of, expandability, I should say, for future projects and just a lot of, nice, neatly overview. So let's just get started and show you guys what I've done. So, of course, as you can see, always started with the beginning, logistics power junction. I got myself a lava tank to actually power the smelteries with lava, which I hooked up to a logistics fluid provider pipe. If you don't know how to set up fluid transfer, the link will be shown right now. Then set up to this, I got myself a couple of barrels to supply the raw resources. For demonstration, I will be showing you how to make bronze, which is tin and copper, electrum, which is gold and silver, and manelium, which is cobalt and ardite. Pretty cool. So let's just get started on the front and the main actual workings of this machine. So, connected to three different smelteries, I got myself a logistics fluid supplier pipe, which is set to keep four buckets of lava stacked into this third tank. Pretty self-explanatory, I would say. And then a smeltery controller, which has a satellite pipe on it, each with a different ID, this one being ID 3, 2, and 1. And these are pretty much identical builds for the rest of the, build, pretty much. I will show you what's around the back in a second. So, then I got myself the three crafting logistics pipes set up to these casting tables. Each casting table set up to be for a specific resource. Again, this one is for electrum. As you can see on the recipe, it's set to satellite ID 3 being 1 silver and 1 gold, giving you 2 electrum. Then on the second casting table, I got myself a recipe set up for tin and 3 copper, giving me 4 bronze. Again, makes a lot of sense. And then on the last crafting table, I got myself set to 1 ardite, 1 cobalt, will give you 1 vanillium. Pretty cool. So then I will show you quickly what's around the back here. This is a little bit more tricky because I wanted to make this system a little bit more expandable than usual. So as you can see, I got myself a smeltery drain on each smeltery, set up to a fluid duct, hardened fluid duct to be precise, and a servo set up to that. The servo is set to whitelist only the specific liquids that you want to be pumped out, and of course the redstone control disabled. And the reason why I had to set up the whitelist for this specific liquid is because otherwise it will try to take out the other liquids while it has not yet formed, or let's say you have two different materials with different smelting temperatures. The machine will pretty much break, and that's not what you want. So always be sure to whitelist the resource that you want. As you can see, the buckets straight up work. I did this with all three of these, so this one is set to a bucket of molten bronze, and this one is set to a bucket of molten electrum. This is getting pumped into a tank, just so I can actually send it along its way through logistics pipes, and connected to those tanks, I got myself a logistics fluid extractor pipe, which, as the name would suggest, automatically extracts the fluids from the connected inventory, again this tank, to wherever you actually got a place to store it, which I will show you guys in a second. So, yes, hope you guys still follow me from here. So, as you can see on here, I got myself the three different tanks set up to the actual casting tables. Be sure to keep a note where I actually put the basic pipes on each intersection. Pretty cool. And then, of course, the logistics basic logistics fluids basic pipe connected to each tank, which is configured to only allow the specific liquid. So, molten electrum, molten bronze, and molten melanalium. So these extractor pipes will only pretty much have one place to put it, which is their designated tank, which I configured in these basics pipes. And then as you can see, I got myself some hardened fluid ducts, which are set to pretty much allow anything, because there should only be the material that you actually configured into this tank be automatically outputted into the casting table, and the crafting logistics pipe does the rest. So let's quickly demonstrate while because this takes a little bit, and then I can continue talking. So let's set craft to, let's say, 4 electrum, 4 manelium, and 4 bronze. As you can see, the resources are being sent to their appropriate location. Pretty cool. So this will take just a second to actually smelt up. That's the only downside with the system, that it's not like instantly on demand, but that it takes a little while. So why would I do it like this and not just straightforward like connect these pipes to the casting table? That's because I thought it would be interesting to, if you want to have your tanks set up on a different location, or pretty much store your fluids somewhere separately. So let's say you have a specific room that you use for storing water, fuel, lava, and again, possible molten liquids. This would be a pretty nice solution. So as you can see, the first ingot is already being sent through. It's sent to the appropriate tank, the servo and the fluid ducts take care of the rest, pumping it into the casting table, and then the crafting table will send it to wherever you requested it, being either another requesting pipe, or a crafting pipe, or whatever. So again, it's working with bronze, manillium, and this should work with pretty much all alloys that can be created in the smeltery, but you can also use things like the alloy furnace for contraptions like this, though because I had a suggestion for the smeltery, I decided to do it like this. Pretty cool. With that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point for this episode. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed, and most importantly, found it very educational. If you have any suggestions or questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. As you should know by now, I always respond to them. Thumbs up if you liked it, disliked it, you know what to do. Other than that, I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.